In this video, we're going to take a look at Assistive Access on the iPhone. This was introduced with iOS 17. Basically, what Apple did is they redesigned the interface to the iPhone and made it easier to use for some people by making everything larger. Some of the apps only contain core features. Let's take a look at this new Assistive Access interface on the iPhone. What we're going to do is first take a look at what it is, and then I'll show you how you set it up. So let's go over to my iPhone and take a look at what Assistive Access is. So this is the Assistive Access interface. As you can see, it looks entirely different from a standard iPhone interface. It is in list format here, but we can change it into a grid format. I'll show you how that is set up when we customize this or set this up. When I tap on any one of the apps, let's go over to calls here. You're going to see it's a much simpler interface. We don't have a lot of features in here. I tap on phone number. I got a nice dial pad here. I go back. And then at the very bottom, I go back. Let's go over to the camera. You know, with the camera, we have a lot of features that are available to us. Well, with this camera, I can take a photo selfie, a video, or a video selfie, and that's about it. So it's a much simplified interface. We can even customize this. I can take out photo selfie and video selfie if I want. So then all the person can do is take a photo or a video. Now, not all of the apps are going to be set up with this new Assistive Access interface. Only some of the core apps are included in this. When I go over to the calendar here, it's going to be the standard Apple calendar. So not all of the apps are redesigned for this. And particularly, third-party apps are not redesigned for this. I'm going to assume that Apple will include more apps, and they will probably open this up into the third-party developers. But for now, we do have a few core apps, and you'll see which ones those are when we go over to set this up. But that is how our Assistive Access works. So now, how did I set this up? Well, it's pretty easy to do. There are a few settings for it, but it's actually pretty easy to do. What we need to do is we need to go to our Settings app. So I go over to my Settings app here. And then from here, what we need to do is we need to go to our accessibility options. This is an accessibility option. So we go over to accessibility here. And then when we swipe up down towards the bottom, you're going to see Assistive Access. Now, right now, I do have it off. So let's go ahead and set this up. We're going to turn it on and set it up. So I tap on it. And now all I need to do is just tap on Set up Assistive Access. Like I said, there are a few different steps here, but Apple does guide you through how it all works. So I'm going to tap on Continue here. It basically says this phone is associated with John. This is John Appleseed's phone. So I just tap on Continue here. And from here, I can set how I want it to appear. So we can set it for rows, or what we can do is we can set it for a grid pattern. I'm going to go with rows here. Tap on it, hit continue. Now what I need to do is I need to add the apps that I want John to be able to access. So right now, if I don't do anything, there's not going to be any apps. So I have to do is I have to tap on the green plus here for all of these apps. Now they are divided into two distinct areas. We have apps that are optimized for Assistive Access, and then we have more apps. We can add other apps, as you've seen. We can add other apps to our Assistive Access. They're just not designed for Assistive Access, so they're just the standard apps. But Apple does have a few of these apps, and I'm going to assume that this app library here will grow larger. But basically, all we have to do is just select which apps we want. So I'm going to go with calls. I want John to be able to make calls. Well, who can he call? I'm just going to go with all contacts. And if we want to show the dollar keypad, I tap on that. And I hit continue. So as you can see, there's a few different options here. So let's go with the camera. Tap on it. I want the camera to be used for photos, and I want it to be used for videos. But John doesn't take any selfies, so I'm just going to leave those off there. We're going to go with messages here. And from here, I want him to be able to access all of the messages. And if I want him to see the conversation details, the keyboard, or any other settings, I can turn those on as well. So I'm just going to tap on continue here. And we're going to go with photos. I'd like John to be able to access the photos. And I'm going to include the shared albums here. So we can select which shared albums. And now John will have access to those as well. We're going to leave music out. And now we're just going to go over to more apps here. Let's go and add just a couple of more apps. John likes to use Bing, so we're going to go with Bing here. I'm going to allow it for motion and fitness. And we're going to allow Bing to use a camera. Maybe there's a QR code or something like that. And I want Bing to access all of the photos if he wants to upload a photo. So as you can see, there is a few different settings here. I'd like Bing to use the location, and this should be able to access the microphone in case he wants to use ChatGPT with it. Let's go with the calculator. John might want to use the calculator, and he might want to use the calendar. The calendar is not set up for assistive access. You're going to see that it's going to be the standard calendar, but I will allow him to have access to that calendar. So now I have John set up for a few different apps here. I tap on continue, continue, and from here what we need to do is tap on continue for my face ID and passcode. So I'm going to enter in a passcode here. You don't want to forget this. And I'm going to go not now. I know what the passcode is here. And now all I need to do is just tap on continue here, and it is ready to use. So now how do we turn it on and off? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to triple click on the side button over here to the right. So I'm going to turn it on here. I enter in that code that I put in earlier. It is now entering assistive access. So basically it's doing a soft reboot here. And then what you're going to see is my new interface for the iPhone using assistive access. And now we have my new interface using assistive access. So if I want to make a call, all I have to do is just tap on calls. You're going to see that the interface has been redesigned and I can easily call Beth. All the contacts will be here. I go down to the bottom to tap on back and it brings me back. Let's go over to the camera. You're going to see that I basically have two options. Remember, I set it up for photos and videos. It cannot take a selfie. So I have my simplified interface here. We go back. When I go to photos, I can view my albums here, tap on any one of them to look at a photo. And when I go over to my calendar, now the calendar was not optimized, so it's going to open up to the standard calendar. This is not optimized for this assistive interface. Now you may be wondering, how do we get back to the settings? How can I go back to the standard interface? Maybe I want to go to my control panel. Well, the way that we do that is we triple click on the side button. So I'm going to triple click on the side button, the sleep wake button, 1, 2, 3. And now we can see we have our settings emergency and we can edit it or exit it. I'm sorry. So I go over to settings. I enter in the code. And now we have my simplified settings here. I tap on back. It takes me back. If I want to exit this, maybe I want to get back to my regular interface, I want to add more apps to it, all I need to do is just tap on exit assistive access. I enter in that code, and now it's going to reboot, and I'm going to have my standard iPhone back. Let's go back here. It rebooted. Now what I need to do is go back over to my settings, and I go over to accessibility, and then we swipe up until we find assistive access. And then from here, I can go add and remove any apps, or what I'm able to do is modify them. Tap on any one of these to make changes. Maybe John does want to take selfies. So now what I do is I go back over to my iPhone here and I turn on the selfies. And now when we go back into assistive access, he'll be able to take selfies. How do we get back to our assistive access? Well, what we need to do is we go back, and then all we have to do is just tap on start assistive access, and it'll go back into that mode. So that is assistive access. Basically what Apple did here is they redesigned some of the apps, as you saw, to be larger. They have just the core features. It basically makes the iPhone easier to use for some people. You can customize what options are available, and you can include all of the other apps. So if you're setting this up for someone and they have a few different games that they want to keep on there, you can add those games. They can still play those games. But they're going to have a simplified interface for some of the core apps that Apple has provided on the iPhone. Now again, this was introduced with iOS 17, so you will need to have iOS 17 in order to use this new feature. So that is Assistive Access on the iPhone.